ProfessorTimmy.org. Here it is. It's a health care plan. Gives all every American health care. Every American, well, I created a health care currency. And they're called Teddy Dollars. And every American will get 5,000 Teddy Dollars on their birthday. And it goes into a health care bank. Everybody has it on account. And everybody would have a health care card. And everybody can spend their Teddy Dollars each year however they want. You want to buy aspirin, pharmaceuticals, you want to buy a wheelchair, you want to go get surgery, elective surgery, anything you want. You have 5,000 of them each year. And you can bankroll them. So after 2 years, you'd have 10,000, 3 years, 15,000, so on and so forth.
Can you trade it to your mother or something if she needs a lot?
I think you should. I think you should be able to allot them to whoever you want. If, say, we as a community, there's a little kid needs a kidney transplant. He and his family don't have enough Teddy Dollars. We could pool ours together. Exactly. So there is a separate market, and the healthcare bank does that. But what I do in my plan, and it's at ProfessorTimmy.org, it's a PDF, you can download it. What it does is it theorizes that the inefficiencies occur in the health insurance market. That health insurance steps in between the doctor and a patient and determines what can be provided. And there are tremendous, by some estimates, there are up to 34% of waste occurs in the bureaucracy between a doctor and the payer, which is a third-party payer, the health insurance. If you eliminate the health insurance company out of it, automatically...
So does this Steady Dollars just cut them out? It's another way to do insurance, but just have a prepay? How can you explain
under this
that in
plan,
another way?
The concept of health insurance does not exist. It is eliminated. It is gone.
Is this Medicare then? Will there still be Medicare, or will it just be Steady Dollars?
It is 100% driven by each individual patient.
And so then, will each individual patient have to do their own price checking and so on, or will there be...
Exactly. And another thing that is required, that if you're going to be a doctor and you want reimbursement for a hospital and you want reimbursement, you are required to put on the website of the health bank what your prices are so the consumers can look. So if I want, say, LASIK surgery, I got Dr. Jones, okay, he's charging $3,000. Dr. Smith's charging $1,000. And Dr. Smith has good ratings.
Okay.
So the market's telling everybody, go to Dr. Smith.
So in other words, now I can use my $5,000 for anything. I can use it for optical, I can use it for ingrown toenails, or I can use it for anything that I want to, right?
Hey, you want a sex change operation. You want
anything that has to do with health, right?
There is under that provision, there is an emergency department within the health bank that can allot special Teddy Dollars upon a doctor's initiated request because of that exact thing. But what's really driving the hype, there's two things that are driving the main drivers of healthcare costs. One are the incredible inefficiencies, which I theorize are primarily from the health insurance companies. And the second is chronic care. End of life and chronic care is just astronomically expensive, and it drives the prices up for everyone. And
so then what would happen with chronic care?
Those chronic care people, I believe in a civilized society that everybody ought to have health care and that it's our responsibility to take care of those people. So the two things that have to happen is, number one, the special department in the healthcare bank would allot money for those individuals, and then also communities can come together and put their community Teddy Dollars together to take care of them.
And you call them Teddy, is that it?
T-E-D-H-I.
Thank you, Professor Timmy.
ProfessorTimmy.org.